Mujer. Hey girl, I'm Micaela, a mother, wife, Jesus follower, podcaster, empowerment coach, and a Chicana who loves her cafecito. I'm on a mission to empower each mujer to give herself permission to be the woman God created her to be. Because just like you, I wear many hats. Girl, I see you trying to take care of everyone else. But on this podcast, I invite you to grab your cafecito or glass of wine, sit back, relax, because I'm going to mentor you and teach you how to stop being afraid of becoming the woman you know you were meant to be. So you ready? All right, girl, let's do this. Hey, girl, welcome to the Fearless Mujer. I'm so excited. So why did I launch this? Why did I do this? You know, as I look back, I really wish that I had someone who would have looked out for me, who would have really spoke into me, you know, who would have really magnified my gifts and my talents and really helped me become the woman that I was meant to be. And so there's so many women out there struggling with their identity. You know, maybe some of you come from a broken home. Maybe you come from a place of not having resources, or maybe you just had to figure it out, right? Not all of us came from an ideal environment. And so some of us, we just had to figure it out and make things happen. And so that's why I launched the Fearless Mujer, because girl, we were called to be fearless. We're not meant to just stay stuck or stay where we are. Or, you know, for you moms out there, we're not meant to hide behind our kids. There's so much more that you were created for. And so that's why I launched this, because being fearless means that, you know, you're free and you're brave. It's another way of saying that you're brave. And so for those of you out there who maybe, man, life has knocked you down and you've really been through some stuff and you've been hurt and whatever it looks like, right? You've had setbacks. I get that. You know, I've been there. I was that person. And so those things and the things that people speak into you and the mistakes that you make and, you know, all the craziness that happens in life, because life isn't perfect. All of that really causes us to start being afraid to walk into our purpose, to become the woman that we were supposed to be. And so, you know, for me, just personally, I've had so many setbacks. I grew up in a really broken home, very dysfunctional. And I didn't grow up in like the suburbs, you know, I grew up in the hood. So I get all that. And sometimes life just makes you a little bit hardened, you know, but at the same time, all of the things that we go through, all the things that look negative, there's always a purpose for it. There's always a reason why. And it doesn't mean that, you know, I'm saying, oh, it's good that you went through all the bad things. What I'm saying is that all the bad things, all the negativity, all the hard things, all the setbacks, that's exactly what's going to make you. That's exactly what's going to create you into the woman that you need to be so that you can serve others and so that you can be a light and you can help others. So, mujer, I'm here to encourage you. That's what this podcast is for. It's for me to empower you. It's for me to equip you. It's for me to tell you that you don't have to look around anymore and ask for permission to become the mujer that you were meant to be. You were meant to be a woman, a great woman. And look, maybe you didn't have a role model. Maybe you didn't have someone to look up to, right? Maybe you didn't have the perfect mother, whatever, however you want to call it, right? But you can be that woman that you didn't have. And so that's exactly, like I said, why I launched the Fearless Mujer, because I'm on a mission to empower each woman to really become the woman that she was meant to be. And when I say like asking for permission, you know, I'm a Chicana, I'm Mexican, right? I'm Mexican American, and I was raised by a Mexican man who it was like, you guys know, if you're Latina and you're listening, you get what I'm saying, right? Or if you had really strict parents and you had to ask for permission. But if you don't happen to be Latina, right, you've probably seen the memes of like the Mexican mom or the Hispanic mom that's like, where are you going? And the kid's like 20 something years old and like, oh, I got to ask for permission, right? I think it's called Me Too, where they do all those funny videos and stuff. But the friend's asking the other friend, like, hey, bro, you want to go to this party? And he's like, I got to ask my mom. And so he's like, what? You know, and he's already like an adult. So you get what I'm saying, right? Asking for permission to do fill in the blank. And so I think that we embrace that and we kind of carry that into adulthood. And then for you out there who are moms, or maybe you were an older sibling who had to take care of everyone else, like, you never really stop to think about taking care of you, because you learn as a little girl that you got to hustle and you got to make it happen. You got to step it up, right? And you got to do what you got to do. But then there comes a time where you know that you have to take care of you. Like, maybe your career isn't where it should be. Maybe you're a stay-at-home mom. Maybe you're a wife and you're content with taking care of your family. And girl, there is nothing wrong with that. That is such a beautiful, noble thing to do. But you know what happens when we're taking care of everyone else? We're hiding behind that. We're hiding behind it because in some way we're comfortable, we feel safe, we feel secure. But let me ask you a question. What would happen if you really stepped out and did and walked into what you know you were supposed to do? Like, you ever get a little spark in your heart because you're like, man, I would love to write a book. I would love to speak. I would love to start a podcast, right? During quarantine, nacieron todas las podcasts. And for those of you who don't speak Spanish, I said a lot of podcasts were birthed. A lot of podcasts just kind of came out of nowhere. And you know what? That's an awesome thing, right? It's an awesome thing because as a woman, your voice is so powerful. So girl, if you've been feeling like, man, I think I want to do this thing, but you don't know how to do it, let me tell you something. That's okay. There is the internet, right? We all know of it. YouTube, all that good stuff. There's so much information on there. And then you have, you know, people who have podcast universities, you have courses, you have all that stuff. Maybe you know someone who's already done it. So this is my second podcast. So for me, I kind of feel like, okay, well, I kind of know what I'm doing. I got the basics. I figured that out. I'm good. Let me do something new here, right? Again, that was on my heart because I really believe that something powerful happens when women lift each other up and women speak life into each other. And so, like I was saying in the beginning, so I started the Fearless Mujer because sometimes we didn't have someone who affirmed us or who allowed us to really voice how we felt about something or really to talk about our dreams, right? Or maybe somebody criticized us or made our dreams seem like they weren't a big deal. And so I'm here to tell you that, you know, you need to go back to that place. When you had those dreams on your heart, if you feel like you lost who you are, if you feel like you've lost the woman that you are and you don't even know where to start, and you know, it's not a good feeling when you feel like you're lost, when you feel like you don't have clarity, when you feel like you don't even know where to start. But what I will tell you is that that's actually a good place to be in, because when you're in that place, though it's real uncomfortable, girl, guess what happens? You start to question, what are you doing? You start to question, who am I really? And that's when you begin to really dig deep and look inside of yourself and ask yourself, what do I really want? And so for those of you who are like, if you're in your 20s and you're listening, when you get to be like in your 30s, you're like a different person. You will become a different type of woman. And, you know, they're all different seasons that we go through. And so what you want in your 20s sometimes isn't what you want in your 30s. So, yeah, so that's why I did this, because if no one's speaking into you, if no one's lifting you up, if no one's speaking life into you and telling you, hey, you know, I don't know what your name is, but we're just going to call you Catalina, Michelle, Whatever your name is, girl, whatever your name is, whoever you are listening, I'm happy you're here. But look, if no one said to you, you're smart, you're beautiful, you got this, you can do this, go after your dream, go chase it. If nobody told you that, I'm going to be the girl that's telling you that. I'm going to be that big sister, that friend, that comadre that never, you know, that comadre that's going to speak into you, that's going to tell you, girl, look in the mirror. Because you could do this. And so the other thing is, let's be real. When you're, you know, this is for everybody, right? Sometimes we kind of do what our parents want us to do. We kind of try to find our identity in who they say we are and what they want us to do. And then we don't want to disappoint them, right? But what if you were called to do something that maybe no one else in your family has done? Right? What if you were called to open up a business? And then when you tell people around you, they're like, nope, girl, that's crazy. You can't do that. No, that doesn't sound good. You know, stuff like that. But let me tell you, if that is on your heart, there's a reason why. And usually it's like something that won't go away. You just can't forget about it. It's constantly there nagging you because you know that you have to do this thing. Guess what? Your creator put that inside of you because there's something meant for you to do. You have this purpose that's bigger than what you can see. So if you've lost yourself and if you feel like, man, I remember when I wanted to do this and I had big dreams, go back to that place. Go take your journal, write it down. And so I'm real happy you're here because I want you to know that if you've been looking for that big sister to speak into you, that big sister that you can trust with your heart and your dreams, you came to the right place. So I'm on a mission to empower each woman to stop asking for permission to be the person she was meant to be. And that's why I started this. I started it for you because I'm going to mentor you and I'm going to teach you and I'm going to bring women on here who are going to speak life into you, who are going to magnify your gifts, right? How many times has someone broken you down and talked bad about you and betrayed you and backstabbed you and just criticized the heck out of you? How do you feel after that? You feel like garbage, like, let's be honest. But that's not going to happen here. Here, you could kick back, you could relax because I'm going to speak into you, girl. If you allow me to, I'm going to speak into you. And I hope that the words I say to you, you embrace them, you take them, you think about them, because I didn't have that. I didn't have that growing up. I didn't have a woman to mentor me. I didn't have a woman to look up to. I didn't have someone that I could really trust with my heart and my dreams. I had a lot of people tearing me down and really speaking words of death over me. But, you know, one day, by the grace of God, look, maybe you don't believe in God, and that's cool. Please don't stop listening. But God has been the one who has given me peace and sanity and really purpose. So, look, if no one spoke into you, I'm going to speak into you. I'm going to teach you and mentor you and just really help you dig deep into the woman that you are and the woman that you want to become. And so you don't have to ask for permission anymore to anybody, not your husband, not your boyfriend, not your dad, not your mom, not your older siblings, you know, because people are not always going to agree with us. And that's okay. The people who are really for you, they're going to be there for you. But look, whatever brings you purpose, whatever brings you peace, think about that. Think about that. Think about the things that fill your soul. And so that's why this is here. Girl, this is your space. I'm opening the door for you. I'm inviting you in. Like, if this was my house, you know, pretend this is virtually my living room, mi sala, right? This is it, girl. This is where I give you a cup of cafecito or a glass of wine, and we're going to talk. And so open up your journal because I'm going to teach you and equip you and be your friend, be your cheerleader, and be the girl that has your back. So thanks for being here. Thanks for joining me. I'm really grateful and I'm so excited that I'm able to do this. And so if you want to connect with me on Instagram right now. You can find me at The Fearless Mujer. And yeah, let me know what you think. If you love this episode, leave me a review, subscribe, and yeah, I'll be talking to you soon. Have a good day. Hey girl, thanks so much for joining me. It was such a pleasure hanging out with you. If this episode inspired you and empowered you, share it with the women in your life so that they can be empowered too. And could I ask you for a quick favor? It would mean the world to me if you left me a review and subscribed. That way you never miss an episode. And if you want to connect with me, I'm on Instagram at The Fearless Mujer Podcast. You can also come join the private Facebook group. Fearless Mujeres is a sisterhood and community where you're going to be empowered and inspired. And you'll find the link to that group in the show notes. And girl, let me ask you a quick question. Have you been feeling like you're not walking in your true purpose? If you're looking for guidance and clarity and support, book a free 20-minute clarity call with me. We can focus on the things that are holding you back from really walking and stepping into your God-given purpose. And girl, before you go, if you want to screenshot this episode and share it to your Instagram, Facebook, that would be pretty cool. All right, girl, until next time, God bless.